invite everyone to please take the yellow insert in your bulletin and fill it out as completely as you are willing and able and place it in the offering plate when that comes a little later in the service today. Check in on Facebook if you're on Facebook. Like our Facebook page, you can get all the posts and you can share those with folks and good things about your church through technology. So please do that. Next Monday, not tomorrow, but a week from tomorrow, 6 at 5 in the evening is our annual charge conference. Technically, that's the annual business meeting of the church, which doesn't sound like too much fun, but it's a little more fun than it sounds. And if you are a member of LIFT, we hope to see you, but all church members are welcome. We do have a voice and a vote, and Reverend Rose Booker Jones, our district superintendent, will preside over that meeting 1 week from tomorrow, Monday the 23rd at 6 o'clock. Today is United Methodist Women's Thank Offering Sunday. You'll hear more in a while about the white envelope that's in your bulletin, but I want to get on to welcoming our speaker today, the Reverend Debbie Raisey. Debbie, as I said in the early service, I'm trying to do this partly scripted, partly not. Debbie is from Pena. Anybody here from Pena? Raise your hand. Originally from Pena, she's a lifelong United Methodist. She grew up on a farm, had some good parents who made a good United Methodist out of her ancestry, most importantly. And three older brothers, which that's the time we can talk about that. I also would like to add, she's an ENFP. Anybody else an ENFP? My wife's an ENFP, okay. And I'm not. But anyway, she is. So she's, you don't know where she'll be or what she'll say or anything like that, but it will be good. One of Debbie's favorite roles has been the mother of two sons, Chris and Justin. She currently serves with her husband, Reverend Randy Raisey, as co-pastor of Calvary United Methodist Church in Normal. She graduated from Illinois Wesleyan University with a Bachelor of Arts in Psychology, and she and Barbara Zappa were students there at the same time. And she earned the Master of Divinity from United Theological Seminary. Looking around, I know we have another United grad, but I don't know if he's here right now, in Dayton, Ohio. Debbie, will you rise up so they can see you full on and say thank you and hi to you?
Thank you. O God, our hearts praise you. We know that all knowledge comes from you. We ask that you instruct our hearts so our faith may grow and our love expand. Grant us courage to walk in your ways.
Offered for all time
sacrifice for sins, he sat down at the right hand of God. And since then has been waiting until his enemies would be made a footstool for his feet. For by a single offering, he has perfected for all time those who are sanctified. And then 19 through 25, therefore, my friends, since we have confidence to enter the sanctuary by the blood of Jesus, by the new and living way that he opened for us through the curtain, that is, through his flesh. And since we have a great priest over the house of God, let us approach with a true heart, in full assurance of faith, with our hearts sprinkled clean from the evil conscience and our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold fast to the confession of our hope without wavering, for he who has promised us is faithful. And let us consider how to provoke one another to love and good deeds, not neglecting to meet together, as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day approaching. This is the written word of God for all of God's people.
Thanks be to God. Amen.
When Tom asked me to preach today, we were actually in the Cokesbury display area at annual conference. And those of you who have been to annual conference know that when things get a little dull on the conference floor, we clergy tend to meet in the Cokesbury area. Not that we need any more books, but we always have to see what they have to offer. And that's where we also socialize. And Tom nabbed me right then and there and said, you know, would you come preach for me? And I'm so glad that I said yes. Actually, I don't think I said yes right then. I think I held you off and forgot to answer you. But eventually I obviously said yes. And then he said, I said, do you have a topic? And he said, yes, like gratitude, thankfulness, it's the thank offering Sunday. And I thought, oh man, gratitude. I mean, it's kind of like asking to preach on Christmas. You know, what do you preach about? Oh, how about the birthday of Jesus? You know? And every year he's born again. You know, it's like, gosh, how do you keep this fresh? So, as I thought about gratitude, I thought, I don't want to preach about gratitude that is followed by a prepositional phrase. You know, I'm grateful for A, B, and C. I'm grateful for C, B, and D, or whatever that is. In my family, at Thanksgiving, we always went around the table before we ate and said what we were thankful for. And very often, it was the same stuff. I'm thankful for my family. I'm thankful. And every once in a while, I would say, okay, that you can't use that again because somebody already used it. Let's go a little deeper. What else are you thankful for? And I would have some niece or nephew that would come up off the wall and be thankful for a dog or whatever, just to lighten things up. But I would go beyond the prepositional phrase following gratitude. I also want to go past the old adage, which is a good one, the attitude of gratitude. So I want to look at where we can go with this. And so I thought I'd start with scripture. What a good place to start, right? You know, we can